dad or blessed mother is wonderful for me. I just came from Our Lady of Sorrows, St. Mary of Sorrows in Fairfax, where I spent the last 8 years. Before that, I was out in Leesburg, St. John the Apostle for 5 years, and before that, I was a family pastor in the Holy Trinity Catholic Church of Hazel. I'm originally from Philadelphia, in the city of brotherly shove, as they say. Great to be here, and I love talking about the saints because we're all called to be saints. Because we want to follow the example of the saints, we want to imitate their virtues, and we want to ask their intercession. So we look for a moment at the life of Bishop St. Irenaeus. St. Irenaeus is a bishop, martyr, and a father of the church. He's considered an apostolic father because he was a disciple of St. Polycarp, who was a disciple of St. John the Apostle, who was called by Christ himself. He's an apostolic father, direct connection back to Christ and St. John the Apostle. Pope Francis named him the newest doctor of the church a few years ago. The bishops of France petitioned the Pope to have a new doctor of the church, St. Irenaeus from Lyon, France. He was actually born in Asia Minor. If you ever play Catholic trivia and they say, where is the saint from? You say Asia Minor, you know, they will most likely get it right. That's modern day Turkey, but he lived in Gaul, modern day France, and the bishops of France petitioned Pope Francis to have Irenaeus declared the doctor of the church. And the Pope asked every bishop's conference around the world if they agreed. And every bishop from the United States agreed to have him a doctor of the church. And one bishop joked that that was the first time all the bishops ever agreed on anything. So that's a wonderful thing. So he is the newest doctor of the church. It's called the Doctor of Unity because he came from the East, lived in the West, and his teachings helped to unify the church. He would write his 5-volume book called Against the Heresies, Against Gnosticism, that you had to have secret knowledge to be saved, Against the Marcionites, who claimed that the God of the Old Testament was not the same as the God of the New Testament. And so Irenaeus was able to show that it is the same one and true God. And then, if you want to read the writings of Irenaeus, just go to the Catechism of the Catholic Church, because next to St. Augustine, he's the most quoted saint in the entire Catechism of the Catholic Church, of 30 quotations. It's a great way to read just a paragraph of his writings. He wrote about the real presence of Jesus in the Eucharist. He wrote about the primacy of the first pope and the primacy of the papacy. He also wrote and helped to list the canon of the Bible. And this was later confirmed in Catholic teaching. And then he talked about the marriage role as the new Eve, that the first Eve tied the knot of sin, Mary loosened the knot. She's the undoer of knots, and she is called the new Eve and the Theotokos, the God-bearer. So today we ask the intercession of St. Irenaeus, the bishop and of unity, and I'll give you a blessing now with the relics. I have, don't have a relic of St. Irenaeus, but Irenaeus, we do have a relic of St. Polycarp and St. John the Apostle. So I'll give you a blessing with these relics of these holy men who helped form St. Irenaeus to be the great bishop and defender of the faith. And it's so important to read the fathers of the church.